Hi everyone, welcome to this channel. Learn Chinese with Mu 和牛牛一起学中文。In this video, I'm going to talk about interview, and I will introduce a lot of vocabularies and also some useful sentence patterns that you can go along with it. And now, let's begin. The first word, interview. 面试面试 Jobs 工作工作 Job interview 工作面试工作面试 Apply for college 大学申请大学申请 College application interview 大学申请面试大学申请面试 So here is the sentence pattern. If you want to tell people you at what time have what kind of interview, here is the perfect sentence pattern. 我在什么时间有个怎么样的面试？我在什么时间有个怎么样的面试？ So now, let's see the sentence to learn how to use this sentence pattern. Here, the first sentence is, Last Friday, I had a college interview. First, I want to ask you how to say last Friday.
上个星期五上个星期五
And then how to say college interview?
大学面试大学面试
So let's go back to see the sentence pattern and see how to put these two words into the sentence. So here is the sentence pattern.
我在什么时间有个怎么样的面试?
So what you have to do is just to put last Friday and also what kind of interview into this sentence pattern.
我在什么时间有个怎么样的面试?
So now, let's put this together to say this sentence. Last Friday, I had a college interview.
我上个星期五有个大学面试。我上个星期五有个大学面试。
Now it's your turn to say this sentence.
我上个星期五有个大学面试。
And here is the second sentence. This Monday at 2 p.m., I had an interview. First, let's see the time. This Monday in Mandarin is
这个星期一这个星期一
2 p.m.
下午两点下午两点
And don't forget the sequence of the time. So now, let's say this sentence. This Monday at 2 p.m., I had an interview.
我这个星期一下午两点有个面试。我这个星期一下午两点有个面试。
Now it's your turn to say this sentence. This Monday at 2 p.m., I had an interview.
我这个星期一下午两点有个面试。
And here is another sentence. Next Wednesday at 10 a.m., I will have a job interview. First, I want to ask you how to say next Wednesday.
下个星期三下个星期三
And then how to say 10 a.m.
早上十点早上十点
And then how to say job interview?
工作面试工作面试
So now, let's say this sentence. Next Wednesday at 10 a.m., I will have a job interview.
我下个星期三早上十点有个工作面试。
我下个星期三早上十点有个工作面试。
Now it's your turn to say this sentence. Next Wednesday at 10 a.m., I will have a job interview.
Prepare,
准备,
准备。
Interview questions. 面试题目,
面试题目。
So if you want to tell people before the interview, you have to practice the interview questions. How to say this sentence? First, I want to ask you how to say before the interview.
面试之前,
面试之前。And then how to say practice.
准备好,
准备好。And then how to say interview questions.
面试题目,
面试题目。So now let's combine this to say this sentence. Before the interview, you have to practice the interview questions.
面试之前,你要准备好面试题目。
面试之前,你要准备好面试题目。Now it's your turn to say this sentence.
面试之前，你要准备好面试题目。
Resume，
个人履历，
个人履历。So here is another sentence. Before the interview, you have to write the resume. How to say before the interview?
面试之前,
面试之前。And then how to say write?
准备好,
准备好。And then how to say resume?
个人履历,
个人履历。And now, let's say this sentence. Before the interview, you have to write the resume.
面试之前,你也要准备好个人履历。
面试之前,你也要准备好个人履历。Now, it's your turn to say this sentence.
面试之前，你也要准备好个人履历。
Good manners, 礼貌，
礼貌。
During the interview, you need to show good manners. So how to say during the interview?
面试的时候，
面试的时候。And then how to say good manners?
礼貌,
礼貌。So let's say this sentence.
面试的时候,你要有礼貌。
面试的时候,你要有礼貌。Now it's your turn to say this sentence. During the interview, you need to show good manners.
面试的时候你要有礼貌。
Professional closing.
专业的服装,
专业的服装。Like dress,
洋装。
Suit,
西装。
So here it says, during the interview, you need to wear professional clothing. How to say during the interview?
面试的时候,
面试的时候。And then how to say professional clothing?
专业的服装,
专业的服装。Now let's say this sentence.
面试的时候, 你要穿专业的服装。面试的时候，你要穿专业的服装。
Now it's your turn to say this sentence. During the interview, you need to wear professional clothing.
面试的时候，你要穿专业的服装。
Thank you note.
感谢信，感谢信。
Here is another sentence. After the interview, you have to write a thank you email. And then how to say after the interview?
面试之后，面试之后。
And then how to say right?
准备好，准备好。
And then how to say thank you note or thank you email?
感谢信，感谢信。
So now let's say this sentence. After the interview, you have to write a thank you email or a thank you note.
面试之后，你要准备好感谢信。面试之后，你要准备好感谢信。
Now it's your turn to say this sentence.
面试之后，你要准备好感谢信。
I know there are so many words and sentences that you have to remember in here, but once you remember this, this will help you to prepare for the AP Chinese writing and the speaking part. Like conversation, sometimes he will ask you something about the interview, and this will be a great resource for you to prepare this topic about interview. So I would suggest you to remember the vocabularies and the sentences that go along with it. I hope you find this video is really useful to you, and I hope to see you next time in my next video. Bye-bye!